Hi everyone, now we are going to discuss about the topic of electromyography, in short it is EMG. Electromyography is a technique for evaluating and regarding the electrical activity produced by the skeletal muscles. The EMG is performed using an instrument called as electromyograph, and the pattern recorded is called as electromyogram. The resting muscle does not show any recordable electrical potential, but with increasing force of contraction, amplitude of potential increases. So whenever you start working with an activity, it was noticed that the potential, the electric potential produced by the muscles are keep on increasing. So we have a word. The electromyograph detects electrical potential generated by the muscle cells when these cells are electrically or neurologically activated by means of either contraction or it get relaxed. Basically, a muscle at the relaxed position doesn't produce any voltage. So, EMG signals are generated in case of muscle contractions alone. So, we have another option of definition regarding EMG to be termed as electrical signals associated with the contraction of a muscular is called an electromyogram. So regarding the history of EMG, the concept of electrical existence of electrical output from the muscle was identified by Machi in the year of 1838, whereas by 1929, there is a coaxial needle electrodes were introduced, by means that the technology started developing to analyze the electrical signals produced by the muscles. And regarding the concept of factors involving on production of electromyographic signals are velocity of shortening or lengthening of the muscle, fatigue, continual stress and reflex activity. So EMG serves as an additional aid to neurological examination in clinical practice for identifying and characterizing disorders of motor unit, including anterior horn cells, peripheral nerves and enam junctions and muscles. If you want to know about what is motor unit, so it's nothing but by human physiological, muscles are the physiological motors of the human body. We already known well, brain is the overall controller of a human body. So from the brain, all the muscles are interconnected by means of neuron activity. So from the spinal cord, certain neurons wires are connected, neuron connectivity is happening. So we say that is to be named as motor unit. There are a single motor neuron with all the muscle fibers innervated by its constitute a motor unit. It's a functional unit of motor component of peripheral nervous system. So there are two types of motor units are available. One is slow firing fatigue resistant and the next one is fast firing fatigue units. Whenever you saying about motor units related to the veins connected to the muscles from the spinal cord, we have a word motor unit potential. It's nothing but the sum of action potentials produced in the muscle. So the MUP is characterized by its duration, number of phases, amplitude and rate of rise of first component. So how we got potential from the muscle? We say the word muscle activation. So measurement of electrical signals within the muscle was measured with two electrodes. A summation of the action potential generated during the contractions due to a change in the cell's membrane potential. So once the action potential is generated at the end plate, a depolarizing wave travels all along the length of the muscle fiber with respect to the reference electrode, the potential was measured. So the strength of the current decreases in proportion to the square of the distance from the dipole in the skeletal muscle fiber. So when two electrodes are placed apart, the dipole of the field strength varies at the two electrodes, thereby generating a potential difference between them. So which producing a voltage between the two electrodes, which is to be named as the electrical activity of the muscle, to be analyzed by EMG, electromyography. So with respect to the system, the required components are electrodes to measure the electrical potential difference, and an amplifier is required. Then a third one is filter, and fourth one is display mechanism. So these are the four important component requirement of producing electromyographic unit. So just notice the general diagram of electromyographic unit. So it have a detection surface, we have one electrode that is connected with one amplifier, is about an operation amplifier to verify the potential difference, and one more electrode is connected with reference electrode. So the potential difference between that two electrodes are measured and given as EMG output signal. So the most important requirement for EMG is electrodes. So there are two types of electrodes are available. One is surface electrodes, otherwise it said is extra muscular electrodes, whereas the next one is needle electrodes, that to be named as intramuscular electrodes. So surface electrodes are placed over the muscles, it is an outer layer, whereas needle electrodes are injected into the muscle, so that's called as intramuscular electrodes. Then the next requirement is a high gain amplifier from the range of frequency range of 10 to 5000 hertz. So which is to be connected to an oscilloscope. So oscilloscope traces may be photographed or to be stored on a magnet tape or to be given with the computer for external analysis. So EMG signals may be fed to an audio unit for an spot feel of the signals also is possible, because the frequency is near to audible range, so you can connect the signal to audio level also. Then an arrangement for recording the output, that to be named as display mechanism. So regarding the first requirement for EMG, we need of electrodes, the most important area of EMG. So regarding the types of needle electrodes, we have four options are available. The first one is bipolar needle electrode, the next one is monopolar needle electrode, the third one is single fiber needle electrode, and the next one is macro electrode. In that, bipolar needle electrode is further classified as concentric bipolar needle electrode and coaxial bipolar needle electrode. So you just seen the diagram given here. Out of that, we are mostly using concentric type bipolar electrode. So which consists of a cannula. A cannula is nothing but a thin tube to be inserted into the vein or a body cavity to administrate the medication, with two wires within. So which means the two wires are connected individually to two types of electrodes. So it records the potential difference between the two wires, as one act as active and other one is reference. So it records from a very localized area. Activity from only few muscle fibers is picked up. So these are the conditions of concentric bipolar electrodes. If you go with the next case, monopolar electrode, you say the name itself we have meaning, monopolar means a single electrode. So electrode inserted into the muscle act as a active electrode, whereas a reference electrode is placed over the surface. So due to wide separation of the electrodes, the resolution of low amplitude signal is better, however the noise also get amplified. Whereas if you go for the third option, single fiber electrode, it has a smaller leading edge to record from single muscle fiber rather than a motor unit. So like concentric bipolar needle, it has a cannula with a wire inside, but the wire is bent towards the side of the cannula before few millimeters behind. So by means that the fiber is acting as an active electrode, whereas the edges of the single fiber electrode is acting as a reference itself. The fourth option is macro electrode. It's as like single fiber, it to be used for motor unit measurement system. So these are the four varieties of electrodes used in EMG, electromyographic unit. So the next requirement is amplifiers. Because of the electrical activity of the muscles are very minimum, the amount of voltage to be produced of the order of 1 microvolt to the maximum of 1 millivolt. So we need to raise the level to at least 1 volt per centimeter. So that needs with a gain of at least 10^3 to 10^6 times of gain we are expecting. So differential amplifiers increases the amplitude of the desired response while rejecting unwanted noise. So an amplifier ability to reject common signals is known as common mode rejection ratio. So the higher CMRR is a better rejection, so which is used for as a differential amplifier in the system. The next one is gain. We already known that the signal to be get is very minimum in the microvolt order, so that to be amplified to the voltage range. So we need a good amplifier gain to extend the input signal. Regarding the display sensitivity, that describes the visible waveform and is expressed as volt per division or volt per centimeter in the display device. For this case also we require a high gain amplifiers. We already known well the signals what is produced by the muscles are having so much of noise. So we are working with a selective noise filters are to be employed, especially band pass filters from the range of 10 Hz to the maximum of 10 kHz is commonly used for the system of EMG. And the last component recommended is display. So basically display process is involved to verify the visible analysis. Otherwise it may be connected to an audio system, because the output frequency to the maximum extent of 10 kHz at most of 5 kHz from 10 Hz to the maximum of 5 kHz is the frequency range, so it is in the audible region. So the output of the EMG may be connected with an audio system by means that activity will be heard at the same time. And you just notice about the circuit diagram of the EMG. And then regarding the process, we already known well the first initial process of EMG is signal pickup. So once a signal is picked up by electrodes, that is given with amplification and filtering. After amplification and filtering of noise, that signals are converted from analog to digital. So once this conversion is happening up, and then it is connected with a suitable display system, either to be stored with the computer for future references or otherwise to be given with a CRO or an audio system by means that to analyze the output of the muscle activity. We just notice the equation for how much of voltage output from the EMG circuit and gain of the system. We already known well muscle signals are always analog in nature. So the EMG signals are also collected over a specific period of time. So it may not be taken the short time. So you just take the EMG signals for a duration of time. So the electrical sources in the muscle membrane potential is up about 70 millivolt alone. So measured EMG potential range from less than 50 microvolt to the maximum of 20 to 30 millivolt depending on the muscle under observation. So typical repetition rate of muscle unit firing is about 7 to 20 Hz. So on the right side you can notice the analog version of sine wave, and what about the wave we got from EMG regarding the muscle contraction. And how the signals are processed? So you just notice the diagram number 1. It is of a raw signal. So the signals as what we received from EMG. So whenever we are applying of activity to the muscle, so muscle get contracted, because muscle at relaxed position doesn't produce any more voltage. So once muscles are given activated, we have a chance of voltage is produced with respect to the work done on the muscles. So we have an active region. So it is feel that we have so much of noise level. And then you just find for better comparison, we are working with CMRR, common mode rejection ratio is applied. with respect to the rectifier, we are using a full wave rectifier. With using a full wave rectifier, the signals from both sides, both positive and negative sides, are to be converted into positive side alone. So just see the diagram number 2, the same diagram as 1, only difference is the signal is on positive side alone. And then the third option is we are just going with filtering amplification and filtering of noises. So once it is done, once your amplification is done with respect to the time and threshold, then both option is filtering. So once you go for filtering of, you will get the clear activity of the muscle. So these are the process involved in EMG. Now we are going for the topic of why we need electromyography. So they are measuring of muscle activity during it allows an indication to whether the muscle is active, to see relative changes in the timing of the muscle, to assess motor control and coordination, to determine any evidences of spasticity, and to evaluate muscle function in post-surgical transfer. So these are the need of, these are the points what we require electromyography. Whereas if you go for electromyography, it does not inform about the strength of muscles. That's very important. It's never indicate about the strength of muscle and what type of movement in the signal represent, and whether the activity is compensatory or the primary abnormality. So these are the drawbacks of electromyography. And regarding what are the factors that affect the motor unit potential, the technical factors are type of needle, electrode, characteristics of the recording surface, electrical characteristics of the cable, pre-amplifier and amplifier system, and method of recording. These are the terms related to technical factors, whereas physiological factors leads with age of the person, muscle examined, and temperature. So these are the factors which affects the activity of muscle that leads with the change in motor unit potential. And regarding the applications of EMG, we already known well, EMG can be used for diagnosis of neurogenic and myogenic diseases, which shows an indicator for muscle activation and deactivation, relationship of force and EMG signal to be analyzed. And the last one is use of EMG signals as a fatigue index. I think you understand the topic well. We'll meet you soon with the next topic. Thank you.